your experience, how do you think pharmaceutical companies can really bring innovation? It's a matured sector. It's a sector that, of course, needs matured minds to help the country put two and two together.
Sure, good question. You see, first thing, in pharmaceuticals, India has done even better than IT. Currently, I'm also the chairman of Pharmaceutical Export Promotion Council. It's from Excel under Ministry of Commerce, under Suresh Prabhuji as the leader. You'll be very surprised to know that India exports $18 billion worth of pharmaceuticals to 185 countries, and that's a staggering number. And the balance 10 or 15 countries are also supplied by the countries who source their generic drugs from India. So, you know, both renovation and innovation are akin to the pharmaceutical industry. If you did not have the ideas, you would get caught up in intellectual property rights and you would not be able to get there. So in my opinion, entrepreneurial capability and a startup utilization by pharmaceutical, mature industry like pharmaceuticals is immense. Issues like early stage detection of certain drugs which can be produced through alternate means with proper toxicity data is the need of the hour for the country if the country has to go on the innovation path. On the generic renovation path, when you replicate and already existing drugs after patent expiration of about 17 years to die, you have to bring about different processes and make sure that you follow a particular protocol which is aided completely in terms of an inspection and review of your dossier. Face this challenge of data integrity. This is where young data flows, young startups can integrate the data part of the industry in a manner that it becomes impeccable and unchallengeable. So when an inspector comes, he looks at your facility, he looks at your dossier and sees that there is a proper connect between the two, there is synergy, he gives you the approval. Otherwise, you are a failure. And if you are a failure, you go down by at least about 50-100 crores.
Absolutely.
So there is a great space. Yeah, there's a great space for fresh minds who are technology driven to integrate the data with the facility for a pharmaceutical company.
About young blood coming in and taking the reign of pharmaceutical ahead. I want to know what role do you think our pharmaceutical veterans can play here? You know, we know Mr. Habil Khurakiwala very well integrates his knowledge into the new products that he's making, but the knowledge of the experience needs to be percolated to the youth. How do you think this beautiful amalgamation can happen of the knowledge of the expertise of the senior folks with the young and the bright minds of the country?
A very good question, again, indeed. You see, I'll give you an example of a young gentleman who worked with GSK UK, right? A young Indian. He automated their processes through animations. What I mean by animations is that he looked at a particular process and he looked at all the elements of that and put it on a video screen through automation. He translated that to a mobile device which was given to the workers and operators of GSK, and they could learn very quickly because ultimately pharmaceutical quality is driven by standard operating procedures. If you don't follow that standard operating procedure, it's all finished, it's all over. You cannot produce that quality of the drug. So I was very buoyed and motivated by this approach of animation into manufacturing, and we replicated that in our company. With that, he's been able to access to about 40 odd companies wherein people have embraced this automation for the quick, accurate learning of quality management system by the workers on the shop floor. So this is just one classical example. There are several others that the pharmaceutical companies could do well in terms of automating their processes, in terms of animating it and learning it. You see, training is a very vital part of pharmaceutical companies. If you did not train your people properly, we could be in serious trouble, particularly for the regulated markets.
Three tips to young buds who are looking to foray in the pharmaceutical space, specifically because you're also a mix of pharma and now startups.
You see, my advice particularly to pharmaceutical pharmacy graduates, there are a lot of pharmacy graduates who are passing out. there's a massive dearth of qualified manpower who's tuned into the industry. So first thing is industry-academia collaboration, big time, wherein you produce these students, graduates, who are suitable for the industry. And whilst they are pursuing their course, they should get into technology by virtue of which they can do things better. In terms of, you see, rather than going by what the company does, it's better that you combine what the protocol of the company is, bring in fresh ideas, amalgamate the two and take it forwards. This could be a win-win combination and strategy.